What's up, everybody? Once again, it's Brand Man Sean, and this video is brought to you by BrandManNetwork.com because I signed myself. Now, it's about time I did this video because so many people have been asking me, yo, Brand Man, how do we get onto TikTok? How do we make it make sense? It's a little different than Instagram and Twitter and the YouTube. Well, let's make this thing happen. Y'all didn't ask me this when I did a video back in 2018, but I'm not gonna trip on that. What's important is people are now figuring out how relevant it is. Now, again, I was talking about Musical.ly and I was a big proponent of that. And then when they merged with TikTok, I really saw the potential of it, but I'm not gonna talk about why people were so slow to move on to it in this video and why that's relevant for you to figure out how you can hack it. But this is a four-part series that we're doing on TikTok on this channel. So you'll see me go into that in another video. Now, to start this explanation off, let's go into screen share Sean mode.
Now, first of all, let's just start off with the fact that TikTok has its own language. If you aren't familiar, let's pretend we're starting from ground zero. So first, you have challenges. Challenges is the big thing. Everybody is trying to get a challenge that goes trending, or they're trying to leverage somebody else's challenge that takes off. Essentially, when you see these dance challenges, if you can think of anything from the mannequin challenge to the Soulja Boy challenge to all of these different types of challenges, that drives the actual TikTok platform. Another cool thing is the duets. Now, duets are technically a form of challenge, but it's definitely something more unique to TikTok that you don't really see on most other platforms, except for Smule, which is still underutilized. People still check out Smule. Y'all should definitely leverage that if you can. But the duets actually allows you to do your video right with somebody else. You can either collaborate with somebody else on TikTok and do it intentionally together that way, or you can take somebody else's video as a challenge, right? And then when you take that video, you add your own spice to it. You're either acting to that video, responding to that video, and making it interesting. And then a huge thing to understand is hashtags. Now, of course, you're already familiar with hashtags if you're familiar with social media, but the thing is, when it comes to TikTok, they're extremely relevant. Now, there's one huge major tip that I'm going to mention at the end when I get into five tips to leverage and grow your platform on TikTok. But for right now, let's just look at it this way. Understand that TikTok is still relatively new, especially in certain areas, right? It's 1 year old when we look at the American form of TikTok. And the earlier you are in these platforms, the more relevant hashtags are going to be. The reason for this is right now, a lot of people are searching and using hashtags to find certain information, to get into certain niches, and is going to remain a lot more relevant just because of the way that TikTok is set up. Instagram and a lot of these other platforms have things that you forego over time as far as whether you use hashtags to get around or not. Hashtags are still just a relevant portion of navigating TikTok. So when you use hashtags on TikTok, they really will help you gain a following far beyond what they do on Instagram. And if you need help finding hashtags, there's always these hashtag generators like seekmetrics.com and then the allhashtag.com. I'll provide links to those in the description below just in case you need hashtag generators. And I even did a quick Google just to see what would be top hashtags on TikTok. And then I found this article that happened to have 100 hashtags listed. You can Google this article if you want to. I'm not going to actually put the link in the description because really, in my opinion, there's no articles that you're going to find that are extremely relevant when it comes to hashtags, especially as they age. Hashtags and trends are most beneficial in real time. And do understand when I'm talking about hashtags, it kind of goes hand in hand with trends because the trending hashtags on the platform often are challenges and other types of things that are moving quickly. And just like anything else, how you want to do a cover or anything like that while it's early on and joining on, a trend works exactly the same.
The other thing to keep in mind is, yes, there's all these hashtag finders and all these hashtag wizards, like I mentioned, but the biggest thing to really understand is TikTok is going to tell you what's trending. TikTok is going to tell you the hashtags that are popping off at the moment. You just have to go to the page, and when you go to that search section, it will show you that. And it'll be up to you to search and spend that time on a platform to see and get a vibe of what's moving early so you can jump on it early. And of course, take advantage of it.
Now, I already know that some artists are wondering, how do I upload my music onto TikTok though? That's what I want to know. And that answer is pretty simple. Remember, this is a four-part series on TikTok. We're going to go over that actually in another video that's completely focused on it. We're going to have Corey do that. And it's not just music, though. There's all types of sounds that you can upload on TikTok, your own completely unique sounds. You can bang on the chair and get that uploaded to TikTok if you wanted to. Is really what makes that platform so interesting. But moving on beyond that, know that you can make some money on TikTok in a way that you can't on Instagram and a lot of these other platforms. And that's by going live. Now, if you don't know how to go live, all you have to do is click the button, the plus button, and swipe. While you're live, you can take donations from people who are watching, just like Twitch, just like Super Chat on YouTube. And if you're wondering how much money does TikTok take, because of course they're not going to let you make money and them not make money, they take 50%. Now, how I feel about the number, that's not what this video is about. You can decide how you feel about the number. However, it is a way to easily and organically monetize your audience. Going live is a true stream for a lot of these influencers on that platform. That can work well for you as well, because I know a lot of people are wondering, how do I get fans to another platform? How do I get fans to a place where I can make money from them? Well, this is it. All right. And the last thing before I get to five tips to grow your audience on TikTok is the For You page. I cannot talk about TikTok without talking about the For You page. It's a massive part of your success when it comes to TikTok. So what's the For You page and why is it so powerful? Well, let's start here. What is the most powerful, addictive, distracting part of Instagram? Give you a cue. I'll give you a few seconds. One, dos, tres, four, five, six. All right, cool. The most powerful, addictive part of Instagram is the explore page. And when you open up Instagram, you see your feed based on the things that you follow, and then you know, if you want to, you will go to the explore page if you're ready to dance that dance and fight that fight. Oftentimes, I avoid that page because I don't want to get caught up. The difference with TikTok is when you go to TikTok, you essentially are opening the platform directly onto the explore page. For You is their equivalent to the explore page. And most people's goal is to get on the explore page on Instagram. Same thing goes for the For You page. It's algorithmically driven, just like all of this other stuff. And if you can get yourself on this page, you will definitely get a lot of views, likes, all that good stuff. A lot of people attempt to get on this page by doing hashtag For You, and people still do it to the extent where they feel like it is working. Everybody that I know who is doing it and has found success in actually getting on the For You page, they still believe that there isn't a complete loss of hope when it comes to hashtag For You. There is some relevance to it. We'll see how long that lasts, if there truly is at this time. But if you want to get on the For You page, it does help apparently to do hashtag For You. And people also do hashtag For You page. And then, of course, outside of the For You page, if you want to get to your actual page based on the followers that you have, then you just open up TikTok, you see the For You page, and while you're on this For You page, if you swipe right, bam, there is your page based on the people you follow, your news feed, essentially.
And now for five tips to really keep in mind when you're using TikTok, because they're going to be extremely valuable. And number one is hashtags. Remember, I mentioned that those hashtags are extremely important. Well, a big tip to keep in mind is only three hashtags when it comes to TikTok. No more than three. I know on Instagram you might do like 50 of them hashtags, but that doesn't really work on TikTok. I mean, this is coming straight from the people at TikTok. If you have certain conversations, I've had certain conversations, and yeah, man, no more than three. And if you pay attention, you can see that most people pretty much abide by that. I've seen some people push it with like 4, maybe 5 every once in a while. But most people understand that however TikTok has their algorithm set up, that's how it goes. Now, number 2, have your video be only about 11 to 15 seconds long. I know that TikTok allows you to post for 60 seconds, or if you don't know, now you know, but most videos that are really finding a lot of success are 11 to 15 seconds long. Of course, you can always break out of that behavior, but people seem to be, you know, addicted to that shorter period of things, and a lot of things tend to be working. I have seen a couple of channels, I can't remember their name, that did videos that were like 45 seconds, 60 seconds, close to that, but is not the norm on TikTok. Thirdly, we get into just some regular social media internet stuff at this point. Have a great thumbnail. Have a great thumbnail. You are able to choose your thumbnail in the same way you can on Instagram, where you upload a video and then you choose your cover. You can scroll to choose that. You can do the same thing on TikTok. Super easy. Don't worry about it. Nothing too complicated. Number 4, have great lighting. You need the clarity. Even if the video is like dingy or in the darkness, it still needs to have a certain level of brightness for the clarity. Those things are just working. Everything you see working on TikTok, it just has a certain level of feel. I haven't really seen a lot of bad quality videos on TikTok, at least not finding success, where you might find random types of quality on Instagram that find success. And of course, you can do anything on YouTube as well. But the thing is, those are a lot more blog and just general content driven as well, where a lot of this stuff on TikTok, it's still more about the influencer, the person. And I guess that great lighting allows you to connect with that person a lot more. And number 5, collab, man. Collab is something we always talk about throughout social media regardless, but it's just the fact that they allow you to do it a lot cleaner on TikTok. When we think about the duet style, that's something to truly leverage. You can DM people and say, yo, you want to collab with me, and can we do a quick duet? It's so much easier. So definitely take advantage of that. Obviously, you don't want to reach out to somebody that's too many levels up and might perceive it in a certain way, but it is something to do. So collab, collab, collab. Once again, this is video number 1 in a 4-part comprehensive series on TikTok, not only just starting, but how you really blow up. We're going to get into the artist stuff later because I know you guys are interested in that. And also, if you're interested in doing campaigns with your music to really get traction on TikTok, we do that at Brand Man Network. So you can check that out at the link in the description below, how to go throughout that process. This link is specifically for TikTok inquiries. By the time I drop this video, we'll probably have over 1,000 TikTok influencers in our database. So if you're interested in getting connected through that, check that link to go through the approval process. And as always, this video is brought to you by BrandManNetwork.com, because I sign myself, artists who are in Brand Man Network. Y'all know y'all have some kind of situation and discount when it comes to those TikTokers. Hit us up through the network and we can talk about that when that time comes. It's still a process. And other than that, if you like this video, go ahead and like the button. If you like, you might as well share. And if you're not subscribed, you know what to do. Hit that subscribe button.